We collect gently used home furnishings and then redistribute to families in need around Niagara region.
They wanted to start the inaugural chair affair, which has taken place in Toronto, but they wanted to bring it to Niagara and market it specifically for Niagara residents.
We had lots of opportunity for learning and leadership development through the process. Personally, I had not worked on a fundraiser before. So basically there was an idea in place, but nothing else. So we really built the event from the ground up.
I think this organization does a great job in getting that furniture to them, whereas most of the people don't have the means of getting that furniture, picking up at a store, and they're delivering it right to them.
So it's sort of dividing up into a group and drawing on the strength of who's ever in your group to fix that hurdle so that we can get to the next one. And I saw it as running a race, and every race has a hurdle. Everyone has 6 or 7 or 100 hurdles. And we just did everyone as we came to it, and everyone had a strength to get us over it.
I would say it allows young people, as myself and others, to develop these leadership skills where we wouldn't otherwise get the chance to develop these leadership skills.
It was overall a positive experience. So we got to combine, personalities and different leadership skills.
We never have enough beds. Beds are the main thing that bottleneck in terms of what families need. You can get by with sitting. If you don't have a kitchen table, you can sit and eat on your lap in the living room. But if you are sleeping on the floor and need to get up in the morning and look after kids, look after family, go find a job, go get education, that primary need hasn't been filled.
You have a responsibility to help the Niagara region, and through volunteerism, through picking an organization. And so you're building a foundation for people to give back of their skills, give back of their talents, give back of their passion to where you live.